Hi, I'm Elena and welcome to the second day of Vlogmas and the very first video of the Secret TBR Vlogmas. I'm going to get the Secret TBR books. Okay, so we have a lot of package books. In a minute, we're going to choose one of those books to read today. So as it is the beginning of December and the beginning of Vlogmas, I'm really sad because our December didn't start well. 2 days ago, we lost Molly, our cat. She was still very young, but she was very sick. We and the vet tried everything, but in the end, there was nothing we could do for her. So we lost her a few days ago. And we're just really, really sad. So I'm hoping that this can be a good distraction for now. I'm not going to talk about it anymore before I start sobbing. We're just going to pick a book to read today and hopefully that will provide some distraction. We can do a little bit of a guessing game. Because, alright, this feels like a very small classic maybe. This feels like paperback, so this is probably a novel. I think this is also a small classic. It feels like a paperback classic. Oh, this is definitely a novel. This one is way heftier. This is also a novel. This one is also heftier. So I think a few classics, a few novels. I don't know what I'm in the mood for today. I think maybe a novel. So I thought that this was a small paperback novel. So, okay, we're going to open this and see what it is. Okay, you're going to see it before I do. Oh, yes! Okay, this one will be a feel-good. I love it. This one is 84 Caring Cross Roads by Helen Humph. And I think this is a series of letters between a bookstore and a really big fan of the bookstore. So, yes. Okay, this is lovely. Can I read this in one day? 230 pages. Why did I expect myself to read this in one day? Okay, well, a challenge accepted. Let's do this.
I am a poor writer with an antiquarian taste in books, and all the things I want are impossible to get over here.
Okay, welcome to our humongous attic that we do not use except for laundry. Okay, let's get some light in here. I want to say ignore the mess, but that's pretty much impossible. So last year we bought this. So this will just be most of the tree. I think we're not that extravagant, I think, with Christmas trees. Boy's going to get one today and I know he's going to buy one that is way too big. So we have this, but I think we have more. These are the very well, oh my god, stored Christmas lights. So, oh no, it's going to be a disaster. Okay, here are all the other Christmas things. Don't know what this is. I think these little trees I will put in my room, so let's take those. This one I had last year. This one is kind of cute. This is a book we have since we got together, since our first Christmas in 2014, I think. Yes, I'm going to take these two. Because why not combine gold and silver? Why not? And you have a few of my books, so it's quite nice. I am not someone who's willing to spend a lot of money on these things, so here we go. Let's try this with the lights on. You can't even see it on camera. This is a nightmare. So don't ask me if I actually think this is beautiful. I just think it's over the top, and that is absolutely fine. Not at all too big.
What?
It's not at all too big. Okay, so I was just googling the store, because the book, which I am now 50 pages in, by the way, is based on a real store in London. And I found this picture. Oh, wait, what? I found this picture. I'm going to zoom in and you can see the tragedy of the 21st century. It is now a McDonald's. This is why we need these romanticization of these books. This is just, oh my gosh, okay. I'm gonna stop googling now because this is just, it's so depressing. Hi, good evening. I made a little mistake earlier in this vlog. I looked at the number of pages of this book and I thought, how did I think that I could read this in one day? And that is because this is an edition that has both 84 Charing Cross Road and another work by the author. So actually the book I was planning to read is just this little bit. It's only 100 pages and I just finished it. While taking a walk, I also listened to a little bit of the audiobook that was on YouTube, but I mainly read this physically. And this is so wonderful. This is the correspondence between Helen Hoff, so the author of the book, who lived in New York at the time between the 1950s and the 1960s. No, between the 1940s and the 1960s. And she is so frustrated that where she lives in New York back then, she can't find any good English books. And I can so relate to that. Most of the English classics I have to get from UK bookstores, even though, of course, right now books are so incredibly available, especially online. But if I want specific editions, which Helen really did, you're going to have to go to UK online bookstores, or in her case, she wrote letters. She wrote letters to a bookseller called Frank Dole, but also later to his wife and to his daughters and to other employees of the store. And they developed a very strong friendship. I think Helen is, in this day and age, she would fit perfectly within our community because she loves books. She loves owning books. She loves annotating in books. She loves writing in books. I really loved as well that she is very specific about her books. And as she says, I am really quite poor. I'm a poor writer. She wrote for TV shows. She says, I'm a writer, but I still want to own the books. But because right now I am annotating library books and one day they're going to find out it was me, which did shock me a little bit. She wrote in library books, which is not something I do, but I can totally relate to wanting to own the books you read so that you can write in them, especially with classics. And it made me really happy when she said that she absolutely adored Pride and Prejudice, that she wanted a volume of The Common Reader by Virginia Woolf. I looked at some pictures of Helen Hoff and she looked exactly as I imagined her. She really reminds me of my grandma as well. I loved this. This was so heartwarming. This really was a perfect pick for Christmas, for Vlogmas. Thank you, Dad, for picking this book for me. I'm happy that I picked this one up first. Of course, we'll read the other work called The Duchess of Bloomsbury Street, which sounds really lovely as well. I will, of course, read that as well, but I thought I would just keep the vlog for this book. I really love the warm correspondence. She also sent food to London, which there were rations in the 1940s and 50s after the Second World War in London. I believe it's what the letters say. And she was incredibly witty and funny and very direct, very American in the way I think that British people view Americans, which it was really funny because it was in our own words. All in all, really enjoyed this. So thank you for watching the very first Vlogmas video. I was definitely quite cheered up by making this video, by reading this book. Boy and I also went out. It was not the best of ideas because it's the 4th of December today. And the 5th of December is a holiday in the Netherlands. So it was extremely busy with people shopping, a version of Christmas shopping. So that was not wise, but I did buy earrings. Christmas earrings. I will wear them in my next Vlogmas video, I promise, so you can see them. They did kind of cheer me up today, and thank you so much for watching the very first Vlogmas video, and I will see you probably in a few days with another one. Doei!